Hey guys, so today's video I'm going to be showing you my updated version of my filing system. And if you watch my filing system videos before, you know I use a binder system. I don't use a filing cabinet because I don't have one and I don't have that many documents that require me to use a filing cabinet. But I did expand into two binders now. So my original binder, as you can see on this side, this is the one that I'm using now for more of archiving purposes. So more of my medical information, my school information. And then I'm having this one that I just transferred over to this binder that I'm going to be using for things that are more on a regular basis. So I kind of use my label maker and I kind of made a label on the spine here. So basically this is for credit cards, bank, and tax, so things that I might need to add into that on more of a regular basis. And for the tab dividers inside, I use this one which I got at Walmart, which I showed in my supplies haul. I'll link my supplies haul on the below bar. So I use this that comes with the pockets on the dividers. And then for other things within the sections, I use these little post-it flags, these durable flags that I also got at Walmart. So I'm just going to show you the inside, and I did kind of cover up some personal information, so just to protect my privacy and everything. And so in here in the front, I do have a pocket, so if I need something that I don't know where to file it or whatever, I could use this pocket or the one in the back. So first section here is credit cards, and I did label all my tabs with my trusty label maker, the Brother P Touch 90. I love it a lot. And the front section here, I just have my Visa bill, so I just basically use one credit card. So I have all my statements that I need to pay for that month, and I have it in reverse chronological order. So the most recent one is on the top, and this is only for this year. I decided to take the years of the other ones out. I'll show in a bit what I did with them. And in the back here, I have other information that is regarding my visa, but they're not bills. So any other information that they send me is in here. Then I have this section, which is a plastic two-pocket folder. Here I have 2011, so you can flip to here. So these are all the statements, bills that I have for my visa for 2011. And once 2012 is over, I'm going to move the ones from the front and then move them to 2012. And then so on and so forth, I'm going to add another one of these two-pocket plastic folders for the following years. Next section is bank. So any information that it give me from the bank. So I currently use two banks. One is my main bank, and one I just have some stuff in the other bank that I don't really use. So I have one bank on this side. This is for my other bank. And if I do ever need to use another bank or I need to add information, I can only use those clear sheet pockets to attach to this section. This section here is for tax. So currently, I only have my GST checks and GST information that they give me like 4 times a year here. But if I do have my other tax stuff, I can put in here. My mom does my tax, so she has all of my tax information. So I didn't use the back pocket yet, but I still have room for that. And then I just have some blank, these two pocket folders. So whichever section I need one of these, I can just pop it up into that section. So this is the binder that I'm using most regularly to update on a regular basis. And then stuff that I don't do on a regular basis, like I said, it's more for archiving purposes, is this one. I didn't label the spine because the part where you're supposed to label it kind of fell off a long time ago. Whatever, it doesn't bother me. Again, I'm using the same tabbing systems. These are just the remainder of the ones from that section. First section I have here is medical. So I have the first pocket is my immunization card. When I was little, I had one, and it has all the information, all like the shots that I got and stuff. So for whatever reason I need, it's handy because I'm working in a field where direct contact with people. So I need to have that handy if they need to see that. The back here, I just flipped it over, is for optometry. So when I go to the eye doctor, anything regarding my eye. Next section here is dental. So far I just have my orthodontist information. I don't have any of my dental stuff, but anything regarding dental is in this section, and I have it in a sheet protector. Next section is for school, and the first section here is elementary school. So the front side, I have some report cards, some random stuff. I have some photos I got back in the day that I never end up giving to people. And then the back side of this pocket here, the back side here, is just other school stuff. And I use a clip here because you can see this big clip. This is all elementary school stuff, and this one is for certificates that I got, like, you know, honor rolls, different things like that. next to secondary school, so high school. And I also use one of these clips, and this is just for anything regarding high school. And then I have report cards, and they're all in these sheet protectors. And then here I have certificates, so honor rolls or any contest that I joined in high school. And last section is college. So I have the first section is just normal, any college stuff, university stuff. And then I have the certificates one following. And I just clip them so I can tell the different sections. And the last section here is church. And I use the old divider that I used for my original filing system because I ran out of tabs. So this still works as well. So it's just church. And I just have stuff regarding my baptism, profession of faith here. Last section is miscellaneous, which I've flipped it over so you won't see any personal information. I just used the two pocket folders I cut in half, plastic folders, and store anything that I need to store that I don't have a section for. I just put it in the miscellaneous. And I use one of those post-it little tabs to state that it is what this is. So that's basically how I store my files and my very important documents. And I hope you enjoyed this video and got some tips out of this. And I'll see you next time. Stay organized.